शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। रुकारस्त्वंधकारो वै रुकारस्तन्निवर्तकः अंधकार निरोधित्वात् गुरुरुत्तभिधीयते। ॐ सहना भवतु तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शांति शांति शांति। श्रीहरिं परमानंदं उपदेष्टारमीश्वरं व्यापकं सर्वलोकानां कारणं तं नमाम्यहं। अपरोक्षानुभूतिर्वै प्रोक्ष्यते मोक्षसिद्धये। सद्भिरेव प्रयत्नेन वीक्षणीया मुहुर्मुहुः। अहम् शब्देन विख्यातः एक एव स्थितः परः। शूलस्त्वनेकतां प्राप्तः कथं स्याद्देहकः पुमान्। एकः अहम् शब्देन विख्यातः। विख्यातः वेरी वेल नोन। विख्यातः अहम् शब्देन बाय द वर्ड आई इन संस्कृत इक्विवेलेंट टू आई इज अहम्। सो अहम् शब्देन विख्यातः। देर इज वन नो वन हू डजंट नो दिस। एवरीबॉडी नोज अहम्। सो अहम् इज नोन टू एवरीबॉडी एज अहम् अहम् इति। अहम् शब्देन विख्यातः very well known but not properly known. Therefore here ekaha paraha, the one who is known as I is in fact ekaha paraha sthitaha. So look at these words, अहम् शब्देन विख्यातः एकः एव स्थितः। रिमेन्स स्थितः, रिमेन्स एव ओनली एज वन। एवरीथिंग एल्स इज अनलाइक दिस इज ओनली वन। देयर इज नो सेकंड अहम्। व्हाई? बिकॉज it is paraha. Paraha means that which is not limited, it is free from limitation, above limitation. What are the limitations? So there is a threefold limitation. One is time limitation, then space limitation, Then object limitation. This is how you get flower, okay? Anything, any object, any discrete object has these threefold limitation. That this is a flower, not a crystal, not a crystal. This is a solid crystal, this one, okay? So not a crystal, it's only a flower. So if crystal wants to have, all that it requires only a human mind. You give the human mind, any other mind is not enough. If it has got a monkey mind, it will be happy being a crystal. But then it has to have a human mind. Then all complexes will be there. So I don't have any color at all. I always live on borrowed color. So like this, it can have its own problems. So that's a crystal. Crystal wants to be colorful like this? No, not possible. So this is not crystal. This also can have complexes. And therefore, so this flower has object limitation, being what it is. Everybody has got this object limitation. Somebody wrote me a letter. Swamiji, I wish I had wings. Then I wrote back, if you had wings, you won't write letters. And therefore, so this is called object limitation. Then you have next. You have this object has space limitation. If it is here in the vast universe, it is not elsewhere. If it is here, it is not elsewhere. Amazing. We would have had a few more people here. If people had two bodies, one for the Swami and one for home, you know. So there is something urgent there. Can use that body for the Rajan and one body and mind for the Vedanta. But then you'll have two headaches, understand? And so better we settle for one, okay? Two, you can't handle two gastroenteritis. One is enough. Yeah, one is enough. And therefore, so this is what they call spatial limitation. If you are here, you are not elsewhere. Then there is kala paricheda. This is called paricheda limitation. Desha paricheda, spatial limitation. Vastu paricheda, object limitation. Then kala paricheda, time limitation. There was a time it was not. There will be a time it won't be. even when it is there, it is not the same. Correct? Not the same. You don't see the flower. You see always the past flower. How? Swamiji, I see the flower now. This now is meaningless. Your now is meaningless. Meaning of now is timeless, really. Now look at this. This flower, you think you see now, that's because the speed of light is our basis for all our measurements, time distance measurement. The speed of light is 180,000 miles per second. Okay? And odd, not 180,000, another few more miles per second. Now, you see what? The light reflected by the flower. You see only the light reflected by the flower. And the reflected light from the flower has to reach your eyes. Imagine. So this distance, if an ant were to cover, think of it, if an ant were to cover, related to speed of light, it will take long time. This is what they call relativity. It will take long time. This small ant crawling. And on the way also it gets distracted. then stops and then goes and then is leisurely. It's not a human being to hurry. No. It just both ways, both sides it looks at and then goes. Have you seen an ant crawling? You have no time. But you would have seen as a child, you would have seen. And afterwards you became adult. And once you become adult, you don't see these things. So you only see these things. And then you say, so this ant so always looks both sides and goes. Takes so much time. Now the light travels. That is the basis for all of our measurement. And therefore, the light travels so fast, but still it takes time. The sunlight to reach us, it takes 8 minutes. 8 minutes? Bahut door hai. 8 minutes. And therefore, remember this. So it takes time. But it's a very, very, we can't even see, we don't have that kind of a mind to see this length of time as a length. Still it is length. The acharyas had thought about this time. They said you take one many petaled bud, a bud of a flower. So there are 1,000 petals, and you take a needle, and you in one action you send the needle through the whole bud, comes out. Then remove the needle. Then open the bud. In every petal that it has gone through, there is a hole. You know. In one action, you got it that side. Remove that. Then there are 1,000 holes. In 1,000 petals, assume it has made, the needle has made 1,000 holes. 1,000 holes. In not even a second, it has made 1,000 holes. what time the needle would have taken to make one hole? They used to ask this question. It has done job. This needle has done a big job. One hole and another hole, drill karke, one hole, drill again, another hole, and another hole, make another hole, and make another hole, 1,000 holes it has to make and go. Ho gaya. But still it has made. Just to help us appreciate the invisible length of time. But you can infer, you can't miss it. So time is divisible, subject to division. So here, for this light, this flower reflected light, to reach your eyes takes time. By the time it reaches your eyes, the flower has become old, past flower. So you see only past flower. You don't see present flower. Present flower you cannot see. Present Swami also you cannot see. And present audience also I cannot see. Present you I cannot see. Present Swami you cannot see. So both of us are in the same boat. And therefore everything is okay. Only our problem is, you should be in my same boat, in the same boat. Then it's okay. It's accepted. Why? Because I can't handle. If you are in a different boat, okay? In different sphere. So it's okay. This is how we started our life. My balloon burst. That's not okay. Why it's not okay? Because other fellows, my brother's balloon did not burst. That's not okay. If his balloon also burst, I'm comfortable. So this is the child. And therefore, we didn't grow out of it. So that's a part. This is kala paricheda. It is never the same. The flower at this moment is not the flower at next moment. Why? After 3 days, you see the flower gone. Then color goes, form goes, color goes, and everything goes. One good thing is it is recyclable, biodegradable, then it becomes part of the earth. What is eternal is styrofoam. So bio non-degradable. That's why I tell the styrofoam. The styrofoam, this cup has a complex. Suppose the cup has a complex, I tell the cup. So what is your problem? My problem is people don't respect me. Why? They respect you. No, they just use me, have a sip, then throw it. They throw it. These Americans, I don't like to be in this country. Where do you want to go? I want to go to India. Why you want to go to India? They will keep me washing the cup again. One more time they will use me. And therefore I would like to go to a place where I am respected. I have a shell life. Here, it's all disposable. I don't want to be a cup. and I can die any time. They can crush me. I am a mortal. I am disposable, I am a mortal. Then I have to teach the styrofoam, you are not a mortal. You are bio non-degradable. In another cycle of creation also, you will be sitting there. And therefore, so you are not a mortal. Atma is not mortal. I have to teach the cup. Therefore, an object has time limitation. During its life also, it is never the same. And therefore, there was a time when it was not in this form. There will be a time it won't be. During its existence also, it is never the same. This is what is called kala paricheda, time limitation. No object can escape this threefold limitation. Your body also doesn't escape this threefold limitation. You have the family album. This family album is very good. So in India we don't have all that. But here they have family album. It's good. Now and then you can look at it and become sad. You said. Well, therefore, so this body is subject to time limitation, space limitation, object limitation. Being the human body, it has got this particular body with its own constitutional allergy, pollen allergy, dust allergy, some people allergy. So these allergy, you have got varieties of allergy. Constitutional vastu limitation, enough. So this threefold limitation is this body subject to. Then the one who is looking at this body, the witness to this body, is not subject to this threefold limitation. The time itself is object of the witness. Space itself is object of witness. And therefore, Atma Ekaha Parastitaha. It is Paraha. Ekaha San Paraha. So Paraha means so free from this threefold limitation. Desha kala vastu aparichinaha. Whenever the word para comes, unless it has some other meaning, but this is how it is. Desha kala vastu aparichinaha. One who is not limited by time, limited by place, limited by being what it is. How can you say, being what it is, must we have limitation? No. Why? Because what do you say, anatma, not self, is the self. But the self is not self. Self is not not self. But the not self draws its being from the self what is. So what is Atma. Self-evident is self-existent. Everything else draws its existence from the self. This is a very important thing in Vedanta Shastra. This alone establishes freedom for you. That one is Satyam, the other doesn't have Satyam, draws its Satyam from this Satyam alone. I said in the morning, there is chant consciousness. Then no chant consciousness. So what does it mean, no chant consciousness? No chant, that's all what it is. No chant. Chant is action. We are doing it. Chant consciousness. So you set yourself in a particular form where the chanter, the chant, both of them are one and the same. There is a type of chanting you do. So chant consciousness. So you go on doing chant consciousness, go on doing chanting. Then I add one word, consciousness. Because no chant is outside consciousness. It has got to be in the mind. And the mind is a conscious entity. So the whole mind is occupied by this thought chant. And therefore, mind is consciousness. And there is chant consciousness. Suppose you don't chant. No chant. What is there? Consciousness. Therefore, with the chant, consciousness. Without the chant, consciousness. Consciousness is. Consciousness is. When you see, this is an important exercise. You like exercise, you know. Therefore, people like exercise. When I give exercise, make them sit in meditation, when I give exercise, they go to sleep. And then they want exercise. Now here, so this is when you are awake, exercise. This is an exercise. There is nothing to, you have open eyes. Now you close your eyes. Close your eyes. I will say certain words, keep seeing the meaning. Okay. Om. Now, let us start with ye, apple. Apple. The word, see the meaning. Apple. Bus. Bus. See the meaning of the word. Car. Car. Dog. Dog. Eagle. Fan. Apple. Bus. Cat. Camel. Consciousness. Consciousness. Apple. Bus. Car. consciousness. Consciousness. Table, chair, consciousness, 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 book, pen, table, consciousness. Consciousness. Open your eyes. What did you see? Now, let me say, when I said apple, you saw an object, apple. You saw an object. You are the seer of the object. You are the seer of the object. Subject-object. This is called subject-object. You are the seer of the object. Whether it is an object outside or object in your head, it is the same. If there is object outside, then there is a relevant thought, object thought in your head, and that is what you see all the time. That's why we commit mistake. Object outside is one thing, and object inside is quite another. You will not see what is object outside, you will see what is object inside, and you will superimpose that object on the object. This is what we call adhyasa, atasmin tad buddhihi, superimposition. Understand that? Therefore, what is there is a shell. You see it as silver coin. What is there is shell. You see it as silver coin. Therefore, what will be in your head? Silver coin, not shell. Then you, that evokes an action from you. What is action? Bend and pick up. You bend and pick. You didn't pick up. Drop it. Why? It's not silver coin. It is shell. You didn't complete this picking up. You know. That is the time we should take a picture of this fellow. And then send it for people who are seeking alliance, you know. So in India, you know, they seek alliance, and so you send pictures, exchange pictures, photographs. That's that picture. When this fellow is disappointed, the real person will come out. Then that is the photograph which will show the real person. Anyway. The acid volume should be. So, this that's called superimposition. This is what we are doing all the time. We try to reduce this in life so that we are more objective. There is another partial thing it is. A complete screen. Your own unconscious is projected upon the person. What you should tell your mother, what you should have told your mother when you were a child, you could not tell. And therefore, so that is all underneath pain. Now you have a chance to tell. Why? You are married. And therefore, and you can now tell. This is called a transference. This is the transfer. You can tell everything that you want to tell your father, you tell your mother, then you are like this, you are like that. And then he also doesn't know, and he will say, you are like this, you are like that. And then they can't leave also because they like each other. They trust each other. The very transference is due to that, because they trust each other. And so they fight, not having a clue. That's why I'm telling, have some clue. Ask them. Ask the other always, did you want to tell this to your mother? Not immediately. Yeah, wait for a good chance and then afterwards, huh? You tell. Then one can help the other. It's a wonderful thing. Transference is not an ordinary thing. It's a costly thing. It's a costly thing because, so if you go to a therapist, after 3 years he gets it. And unless transference takes place, he cannot help you. All talking is only to get the transference. And to get the transference, you have to talk 3 years. And the 3 years talking means 1 hour, 1 hour, you calculate. So how much you have spent? It's very costly to get transference. And if you are married, immediate. It's cheap. It's cheap. I wish we all knew certain things. So this is all what you see. You see what is in your head, nothing else. Universe may be vast. It has to get filtered through my mind. How much I know, the infrastructure. An astrophysicist will see the universe a little differently. I don't know whether astrophysicist can be a poet, because all his poetry will go away. His poetry will be a little different. If at all he writes poetically, it will be different. Therefore, the infrastructure also makes the perception different. Your background. But one thing, when I said apple, you saw apple. Table, table. When I said consciousness, what did you see? You saw consciousness? No object. You didn't see. Did you see consciousness? No. It's not an object. But was it meaningless? You tell me now. Was it meaningless? No. There was meaning. The word consciousness has meaning. But it's not an object. So objectless meaning, being object, being not an object. You don't need a subject also. Juxtaposed, opposed to the object. Not juxtaposed, opposed to the object. You don't need a subject. There is no subject to object. What is there? Consciousness. You are the meaning of the word consciousness. Correct? Apple, object of consciousness. Table, object of consciousness. There is a subject to object. The seer and the seen object. When I said consciousness, there is neither subject nor object. Then somebody said, that means zero. No. That is the meaning, I am the meaning of the word consciousness. Time, day, hour, week, year, century, millennium, object of consciousness. When I say millennium, it doesn't take 1,000 years for you to understand. Instant. Millennium. Day. It doesn't take 24 hours for you to understand day. Day. Oh. Day of 24 hours. So, no. You just immediately understand what it is. Week. An hour. Minute. Object. Second. Object. Then microsecond, it all becomes inferential. But you can understand what it is. Paroksha jnana. Microsecond. 1 millionth part of a second. It's the same time that it takes for you to understand a microsecond, second, hour, day, week, month, year, century, millennium. Yuga. Kalpa. Same time. All that is you require to know what it is. Amazing. So, the object of consciousness. Consciousness is not bound by time, bound by space, is not one object or the other. It is not one of the objects. Why? Because when I think of object consciousness, consciousness joins, lends its being to the object. I have to discuss about this object, etc. Later we will do. So it lends its being, consciousness, to the object. And therefore, when you think of an object, there is object consciousness. For consciousness to be, you don't need an object. Consciousness is the meaning of the word I, paraha, ekaha. Whereas, he says, whereas, sthulastu, sthulastu anekatam praptaha. What do you objectify like the body? Even your thoughts, senses, everything. Anekatam praptaha. How can you take your body as yourself? Body is not one. You are always one. Body itself consists of a lot of things. One body, you say, and billions of cells, and so many organs, limbs. They're all different. It's just the miracle is different. The miracle is only difference. That's where Ishvara comes. We will talk about it. Ishvara counts for difference. difference with no difference. That's why it's magic. It's all knowledge. In and through that Ishvara's knowledge, which is Jagat, what is there is the meaning of the word consciousness. It is, therefore, Chit, it is Sat, and it is limitless Ananda. Sachit Ananda. This is what you experience whenever you pick up a moment of joy. Sachit Ananda. How can you say this one limitless consciousness, which is Satyam, which is the truth of everything, as this one body, Deha, Kaha, Puman, how that one can become one of the many? That's why Deha, Kaha, Puman. All that is there is one non-dual, and that is taken for one among the many. Katham Purushaha Bhavati, Katham Apina Bhavati. The same thing in the set of verses. So each one highlights one thing. This verse we already discussed, I will read. Aham Drishtutaya Siddhaha Deho Drishyataya Sthitaha Mamayam Iti Nirdeshat Katam Syat Deha Kaf Puman. Drishtri. Seer, knower. Drishya, object of knowledge, object of sight. So, where will you put the drishtra in your body? The seer can have its locus, means its object, the seer status, can this body have? Or the one who looks at this body has it? Who is drishtra? We generally think you are the drishta. Well, uninquired, not really looked into, and then we just loosely talk. But if you analyze, you can very well see this is also drishya. This is also as good as any other, with some special, you can have a special relationship with this body. This special relationship makes it mama ayam deha. Mama ayam iti, mama ayam iti. Here, mama ayam is there. So, mama ayam iti, not dirga. Ayam dehaha, this body is mine. It's my body. Huh. That's a relationship. There are many houses. This house is my house. There are many people. This is my mother. There are many bodies. This is my body. And then no taker for it also. You have your body, it is okay. I have one. Let me maintain this. So mine itself is high maintenance. And therefore, you maintain your body, let me maintain my body. Okay? Your body. you can't buy. This is one thing you don't sell. But some part they sell, kidney sell. They sell kidneys. All these fellows in Arab countries, you know, they have got money without their earning. And so if you earn money, if you have money without earning, is a problem. It's a problem as we see there. So what they do? They come to India and they go to all these poor people and ask them to sell one kidney. Then one kidney they buy, then give them money, one kidney. They do this. Body part selling. And but still, one kidney is there. Therefore, you can still live your life. But one thing I tell you, both the kidneys you cannot give. You can't. This is your body. Even if the other somebody gets it, they have to take medication daily to see that it is not rejected. The body has a certain programming. It knows an alien has come. Without a green card. And this fellow has come. Not only this alien has come, even if he has a green card, on the green card it is written alien. That's called an immigrant. The kidney is an immigrant. And it is accepted immigrant. It's got some blood test and all that was done, a little accepted immigrant. It's got some document. With the document has come, still alien. Still alien, remember. Still alien. Therefore, you have to be very careful. Alien. In fact, in America, all are aliens. The only natives, they are in reservations. They are kept safe. And away from everybody. All are aliens. It's all aage piche. Some people came earlier and some people came later. All are aliens. But they have a certain claim. Our forefathers made this country. Therefore, they are pioneers. We are children of pioneers. You say, still aliens, still alien. So, this body, my body, you have a definite relationship with this body. No dispute, undisputed relationship, provable relationship. There is no question. Mama ayam dehaha. This is my body. That reveals I am drashta of this body. My car means I am not the car. My body means I am not the body. Therefore, what is this aham? Drashtrutayastitaha. Deho drishyatayastitaha. The body is in the status of drishya, object of your knowledge. Mamayam iti nirdeshat, you yourself tell an expression being there, your attitude also being there, that this is my body. Katam syat dehakav puman. This body, this limited body, how it can be the meaning of the Purusha? The Purusha cannot be this body. Ask the same question, a few more verses like that. Akam aham vikarahi nastu. Deho nityam vikaravan. Iti pratiyate sakshat. Katam syat deha kaf puman. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Arihi Om.